Well, that's toast. But fear not, the internet is here with a new one. I'm gonna have to go find that. Last week, we had ourselves a bit of a conundrum. The Moby's camera took a pretty good fall and tumble and rumble in the jungle. And lo and behold, I should give it some props. It lasted long enough for me to get the video off of it, kind of. So we have a new camera. This here is the RunCam2. Two. I got this because it does higher frame rates, which you like for slow motion. So right now we have it set to 1080, 60 frames a second, I think. Something like that. This one also comes with a phone app. So we'll check our settings before we take off. Because it has a little, it's actually a pretty cool little wireless app that can help you change settings and stuff. So far, I like this. I mean, after all, face it, you put the battery in, it turned on, right? Gotta like that. I wanna say, this thing comes with its own external battery, so you can get an extra one. The color LEDs, they don't give you much of a manual with this thing. I mean, it's okay, but it's not the greatest thing I've ever seen. There is a condition where once this is charged, it blinks red. I have absolutely no idea why. To me, that means something's wrong. But according to RunCam, no, that's normal. And it's, guess what, not in the manual either. Go figure. The other thing I like about this and button presses is that you have to actually push it for a couple seconds instead of like the Mobius where you just bump into it and it goes on. So that was pretty nice. So the way you do the app is go into your settings, make sure you're on the right Wi-Fi. I am connected to it, it's a RunCam, so that'll do very well. Close this down, go into the RunCam app, press it, comes up, it will say hit that link that was right in the middle there, and then it'll connect, and then there you go, you're currently looking at my feet. How do you like that? For all you foot fetish people out there, bonus. Now in a normal situation, I would not use this on Wi-Fi, largely because, you know, depending on how your system is set up, you might have already be using Wi-Fi for video, and this may interfere with it. So I'm only gonna use it to check, but as you can see, I can start recording. I can check the settings. Right now, my settings are, 720 by 120 is what I have it set on right now, because I want that 120 frame rate, and I don't put out videos, you know, they're always 720. I like that better. So we are gonna play with this for a little bit, see how it does. We're just going nice and slow, nothing big, and see how the video comes out for this. Mounted in the same place where the Mobius was, and since the Mobius performed very well like that, I assume this one will perform like that. All right, to record on this one, just quick press this button here. The lights should start blinking, and it's blinking, so we're recording. So enough of all this hoo-hockey, let's get flying. I was on the floor, on the bottom, on the bottom of you. Now we can So there it is, RunCam2. Hopefully the footage came out right, and I'm just not talking out my butthole right now. But wait, because it has an app, we can check that. Let's see if our footage came out good. So connecting to our app, hit link, which is the orange button in the middle. Hey, look, I'm binding to your camera. And hey, look, there's some footage right there. Let's see what that does. So as you can see, there it is playing. I think you can see that. Hopefully I didn't get naked during some of that and I forgot it was in the clip. That would suck, huh? So there you go, you can see the footage. So, apparently that worked. I was between the getting another Mobius, which didn't seem to last very well, and this. Also, from what I understand, because this is the first time I've ever had a run cam, it works very well. So there, the internet told me so. So it must be true. And it was, I think it was just like 99 bucks. So that's not bad for 99 bucks. Let me tell you, there's a lot of things you can get for 99 bucks. This is one of the deals. I won't tell you the other, you know, bad things you can get with it, because get the internet. Don't look at me for that stuff. So it is 4th of July weekend, and I just want to say happy firecracker day to you people. We are under the threat of rain between 10 and 2. It is currently 9. Not German 9, but 9 o'clock on the standard clock that we Americans use, or actually mostly everybody uses around the world, but they just don't call it 9, we do, and the Germans call it 9. I think. So that's going to be it for the RunCam. We'll be using it from now on. As we go along, I'll tell you how well battery life is with this thing. In fact, you know, let me turn it off right now. Because I ain't using it right now. Just showing you people. What do you care? So, that said, RunCam 2. View it, like it, and then buy it. Okay, no. Just look around, see if other people like it as much as I do, okay? Because I'm not an authority. I just have a camera and an internet connection. That's all. Hey, just remember, if you like this video, that's right, I'm pointing right at you, buddy, right at you. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you think someone else would want to see this because they want to buy one of these cameras, share it with them. Because sharing is the best thing you can do unless it's a venereal disease. Then that's bad, okay? That's bad. And if you want, subscribe, you know, because I do this stuff all the time. I'm not sponsored by anyone. This is an honest review because nobody's paying my bills. I pay my bills. That's right, because of a damn man. Yeah. On a somewhat cloudy day, somewhere in the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, at an undisclosed location in some hideaway park somewhere that you'll never find. The Mighty Thor, see ya!